We start off this week with some historic footage, some of the first detailed images of a trio of aircraft carriers sunk during the Battle of Midway. Footage from 3 miles underneath the Pacific Ocean brought vivid images of the ships, each a casualty of one of the war's most pivotal naval battles.
The Battle of Midway set the pattern for other sea battles which followed in the Pacific.
Researchers said access to the ship is so difficult because of how far and how deep the ships are out in the ocean.
One of the things that is important to understand is the challenge of working in a place like this. So we are right in the middle of the Pacific. So we're basically, if you look at a map, almost dead center between the coast of Japan and the United States. Our closest point of land or closest point of land where there's actually cities or towns is close to 1,500 miles away, and we're diving over 3 miles deep.
Chronicled in the latest mission to document the wrecks were two Japanese carriers, the Kaga and the Akagi, and an American vessel, the USS Yorktown. All three vessels had been previously located, but not captured in detail.
Three aircraft carriers, two of them close together, and so the two Japanese aircraft carriers are about 10 miles apart from one another. And in fact, so there were four aircraft carriers, Japanese, that were all close together, and they basically that's how they operated in this tight formation. The USS Yorktown is about 100 miles away from that site. The Akagi, from the Japanese Navy. This one represents the very first time anyone has ever laid eyes on this wreck since it was lost 81 years ago.
The video is hoped to clarify conflicting reports about how the battle resulted in each ship's demise.
When you look at the action reports and what we know about the battle, those obviously came in times of distress, in times of chaos, in terms of the battle. And so those historic records are not always as clear as you want them. But we had this kind of benefit of spending two full days on the seafloor documenting each one of these three wrecks in great detail.
One of the first to see the images, 101-year-old veteran Julian Hodges, who served on the Yorktown and had to swim with a dislocated shoulder for 6 hours before being rescued after the fight.
But boy, she took a beating, and I almost brought tears to my eyes, I'll be truthful about it. I just hated to see my ship torn up like that.
The Battle of Midway took place 6 months after the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor.